Good evening, everyone. My name is Nitesh, and I'm working as a regional head in Godrej and Boys. Many people are not aware that Godrej is also in solar, but yes, we are working in solar from past 4.5 years, and we have installed about 30 megawatt solar power plants. I will keep my presentation very small. What we have did, and what are the O&M practices we follow. So this is the content of my presentation. First is about the Godrej Group. So we are one of the oldest group, approximately 119 years of presence in India. Started with the Make in India movement. We have approximately 1.1 billion consumers across the globe. We work on a principle that Godrej in every home and a workplace, which probably we have achieved about 70%, whether you are using in Goodnight or at Godrej fridge or an Almira. So we have a total revenue about 4.5 billion USD. These are the Godrej group of companies. I'm working in Godrej and Boys, which is headed by Mr. Jamshed Godrej, who is Padma Bhushan Awardee in 2003. Rest are owned by Mr. Adi Godrej. So we are presently focusing only on rooftop and on ground mount as well, but main focus is on rooftop. We have pretty good basket to give to a client. For example, we are such a large diverse group that we can offer a one-stop solution. For example, if someone want to build a building, we can my construction division can build the whole building. Then we have a division called mechanical electrical plumbing. We can do the complete mechanical electrical plumbing work. Then we have a Godrej interior, we can provide furnitures. We have green building consultancy group, which we can give the green building consultancy. Then we have a security division, which can give you an GCCT claim. And the top of it, we can supply solar power plants. So under Godrej and Boys, we have one division called electrical and electronic vertical. Under that, there are another six vertical. I'm working in power infrastructure and renewable energy. The total turnover of this particular segment, power infrastructure and renewable energy, 1,000 crores. And here we do two work. One is transmission and distribution work, and other is solar power plant. So this is a purely an EPC company. Then we do mechanical, electrical, plumbing, in building consulting under this electrical and electronic technologies. So as I told you, renewable energy, we have a rooftop solar power plant and ground mounted solar projects. We have executed about 30 megawatt solar power plant, and I'm very glad to share that we ourselves put about 3 to 4 megawatt of solar power plant in our own roofs, because we are paying in crores of bill. Our manufacturing hub is based in Maharashtra. The tariff there goes about 9 rupees, so we are building. So we are purely EPC company, we don't do RESCO, but we build our own power plants. So we have done about 30 megawatt solar rooftop project, 220 kilometer of EHV transmission line, 2500 MVA of transformer installed capacity, and approximately 30,000 kilometer of distribution lines. So total manpower strength of this company, of this division, is 500 people, 500 engineers. There is separate contract management, purchase management, these kind of stuff. So talking about solar power plant, as someone from Renew told me, in the last presentation, that O&M activity starts from the very first day. What kind of a design you are doing it? What kind of a cable size you are doing it? What kind of a lighting protection device, like Vikas told in the, what kind of a lighting protection system you are using it? Whether you have installed surge protection devices or not? Whether the cable tray or conduit are designed or has been installed for a lifespan of 25 years or not. Rest is all cleaning work. So we give complete EPC solution from design to testing, commissioning, and we are doing O&M for some plants. This is the procedure which we follow: material planning, manpower planning, project scheduling, project monitoring and control, high class project review mechanism. So starting from the site survey, the shadow analysis, PV marking area, and charging of the solar PV plants. So the best practice which we follow in O&M is, first we make sure that your design and commissioning has been done so that there is a less error. If you talk about proper cabling for better ventilation, this is one part. Surge protection and lighting protection is second part. Third is the conduits you are using, the cable trays you are using. So these are the, and the second is safety should be, if talk about installation as well as in during O&M period, it should be used, it should be done with proper PPE. We have worked in plants with height of about 130 feet to 140 feet. So safety cannot be compromised on that sites. Then what kind of inverter mounting arrangement you are using, whether it's there is a canopy or not, visual images is one of the key factor in O&M. Then after installing solar power plant, we generally give 1 month training, because in EPC we build from say 10 kilowatt to 1000 kilowatt, not an as a ESCO but a direct investment from a client. So we give proper training for almost 1 month that how you need to clean a solar panel. Second is, if you are working on an kind of a slanted roof, industrial roof, then you need to have a lifeline and a walkway. As an EPC player itself, it should be a part of proposal. Otherwise, the EPC contractor used to cut down the cost. The safety, walkway and lifeline are not considered in the EPC proposal. But I personally think that it should be the part of the EPC proposal. Second is the technology respect. As I told you that we have installed, and as an EPC player, we have installed many plants. So we generally monitor every plant with the generations. So although we don't clean that plant because it's in the customer scope, but we generally call to a client. There is a one incident, I don't want to name that client, but I feel very bad for that. We call that client and we say that your generation is not coming, because your generation is not coming, please see that if you have cleaned the planner or not. Your plant which is installed next to you is generating more than you, approximately 20-30% of the same inclination, same inverter, same module, which is generating more 20%. Please see that you have not cleaned the plant or not. Then he said, oh, it's okay, we will do that. And after 3 to 4 days, again, the generation has not gone up. He has not cleaned it. Then again, my engineer has called that, please, sir, clean the plant because it's not generating. Then so he said, yaar, main apni machine dekhun ya tumhara plant saaf karu. So this is the kind of a response which we generally get from the client. So there should be kind of a technology respect for the operation and maintenance of the plant. So thank you. And the one important aspect, we generally in Gurgaon, there is an the installation is done on the super elevated structure. So if you're designing a solar power plant, you need to take care of the kind of ladders, movable ladders for cleaning of the system. That has to be part of the design system itself, because all the hotels, hospitals are covered with ducts system, so the plant has to be elevated up to say 2 meter to 3 meter of an height. So you need to have a proper kind of a ladder system which you can propose to a client for operation maintenance. So thank you very much.